Welcome back, guys. Today we are going to take a look at what all the fuss have been about, what have been released and how do we work with it. And I will be having a lot more videos on specific topics, just to make sure that this video doesn't get too long. So first of all, we are proud to announce that Batium now have released their Wi-Fi protocol. This is a great thing and I think this will accomplish a lot. We are also today releasing an open source Watchmon software that can be running on the Raspberry Pi. The software is made for actually polling and getting the data and sent to Influx and MQTT. I also release an open source solar inverter software, an inverter software that I have been using for some time for the MPP products. Check that out. There is also a new Raspberry Pi ISO, and that of course includes all the above. Upcoming, of course, a mobile application for the Batium. Stay tuned for that one. I have seen it. It's in work in progress and hopefully it will be released soon. So stay tuned for that one. Let's talk a little bit quick about what's included on Grafana ISO and what the different parts is all about. We have included a SolarSys and it's open source, and we also include the Batium open source. With that said, that means that the Batium protocol is now finally in open source mode, and you guys can also get it. If you want to get the Batium protocol or the Batium code that I have created as an example for it, you can go to the Batium on GitHub. You also have the solar serial inverter system that me and my friend have built for solar inverters. This one can take every system that uses the RS-232 or any other serial protocol. It's still in the beta stadium, but it works and we have been using it for some of the inverters already. On the ISO, there is included examples for the actual MPI and the PCM60X, the PIP4048. If you want to help out on those things, feel free to do that. It's open source and you are allowed to send in both tickets and recommendation or even code changes. To keep this a DIY community, I really hope that you guys can help us with it. Because frankly, I don't have much time to spend on this, and that's why it has been delayed so much. First of all, we dig into the Grafana interface. We have a couple of new things to show, and that's merely just related to the Batium system. The Batium system is, as of today, automatically started. You will have your system meters up in the top here, depending on how your system looks like. If your system has several Batium systems, you can choose them up here. If not, only one will be shown. The default view is rather simple and only shows the basic values. You will see the status mode and the current state of the battery bank. This should hopefully last and do quite a decent job for you guys. So let's go back again. I were talking about the Batium being open sourced, so let's take a look at that. As you can see here, the Batium Watchmon UDP listener is now opened up. You have most of the data inside here. The Batium code itself is rather simple, I would say. I have built a basic configuration file, and if you copy and clone this one, it will be using that configuration file at first. So let me go through how that looks. The configuration file is very, very simple. The first chunk is where you set the MQTT host and the Influx host. If you're running my Grafana system, you do not need to change anything here. After that, we have the configuration for the different messages. The message type ID you have here, and then you set the variables of what to do with it. Default, I have enabled MQTT and InfluxDB for some of the default messages. Not every message is in the configuration file, and if you want to add more, you can do that. It's very, very simple. If you want to send anything to MQTT, just enable it here and it will be sent to the local MQTT database. If we go back again and we take a look at the payload is where all the messages are stored. This is updated by Batium and Yaron, and as soon as there is a new message will be added here. You can see, for instance, this message ID 3E have two different versions, version 32 and 5A. If you want to take a look at any of the messages and have an example for your project, you can go in here and look at them. This is something that I built together really quickly using a binary parser in JSON. As you can see here, you have all the different parts for the messages. You also have how it's formatted to be able to return the correct value. If we go back again and in the docs folder, you will have the Watchmon protocol. In here, the protocol, the latest one, will be updated. Checking that out, you will see what it's actually all about. And as you can see, it starts as the offset 8, and that's because you have a payload in the beginning. The payload is described here. So let's go back to the actual code. The actual code of the Batrium.js is here. I just wrote this together really fast, so it's not a decent or good looking code as such, so don't take it for that. This is merely a system built up for you guys to have some kind of first step into it, and for the people that actually don't want to build their own code. The system is actually working perfectly fine as of now and is included on a Grafana ISO. There is also some documentation related to this. The documentation is rather simple and just quickly explains what it's all about. If you want to take a look here, you can do that. So guys, this is the end of this video. In this video, I just quickly went through what was the news in this big announcement. The first one is that the Batrium is releasing their protocol. With that said, and alongside, I have released an example code that you will be able to use as well. Everything resides on GitHub. At the same time, we released the SolarSys package, a package that I have been using for a couple of months for actually getting data from the inverters and also sending data to the inverters. This is far from done, but it do work, but it need a lot of work. At the same time, I do release the latest and best Grafana ISO I have done so far, hopefully. My webpage is updated with all new information. There will be two links, as you can see here, one for the Raspberry Pi preferred method with the AP and one for the older version where it is disabled and running from the start. There is also information on how to run the scripts and everything. If you want more deeper information on how to install the Grafana on everything and get it up and running directly, I suggest that you check this next video I have in this series. Today I'm releasing three videos. The first one was just a trailer. This one that you are watching now is the actual quick look what have been released. And the third one will be a little bit deeper into how to set up the Grafana ISO. With that said, I have a lot of more videos coming in short on how to work with the system, especially on how to set up the solar stuff. There is also one more thing on the way. There will be in the short an application for your mobile phone. So guys, don't forget about the application for the mobile phone. It will be coming soon and hopefully you like that one as well. So guys, I want to thank you for watching and I see you next time. Bye.